In our planet, we use a huge amount of energy, and we are using it for transportation, to heat our homes, for industrial processes. And more than 80% of this energy that we use is coming from fossil fuels. This is coal, natural gas, and petrol. It is estimated that by 2050, the amount of energy that we will use equals to 28 terawatt. This is equivalent to emptying the Loch Ness twice if the water of the Loch Ness was petrol.
The problems with burning fossil fuels is that they are non-renewable and at some point we'll exhaust them. They also release high emissions of carbon dioxide, which will contribute to global warming.
Solar energy could be used as a replacement for fossil fuels. This is because in just 1 hour of sunlight, more energy arrives at the surface of the Earth than is used by the entire planet in 1 year. Solar energy is already being converted into electricity by solar panels. But as it's not always sunny, we need a technology to store this energy.
Plants have been storing sunlight as fuel for more than 2 billion years. They use the process of photosynthesis. This is where they convert carbon dioxide and water into glucose and oxygen to be used as a fuel whenever needed. Researchers around the world are working on artificial photosynthesis, which is a process of making a renewable fuel from water and sunlight.
Water is a molecule made of one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms. Through a chemical reaction, we can split the molecules of water into hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen can then be used as a fuel and also stored. Hydrogen is a good candidate because it's clean fuel. When it is burned, only water is produced as a byproduct.
In order to carry out this water splitting reaction, we need a dye and also a catalyst. A catalyst is a molecule which speeds up the reaction without being used of themselves, which can be used again and again.
Since September, students from the King's Academy have been working as researchers at Teesside University on a project funded by the Royal Society aimed at developing new and more efficient catalysts for hydrogen production. The project has been very successful, and the students have even discovered a compound capable of producing hydrogen, which will be further developed by researchers at Teesside.
We prepared several catalysts from abundant metals such as nickel and cobalt. We can characterise the molecular structure using a technique called nuclear magnetic resonance.
It's also important that we calculate the efficiency of the catalysts. We can do this by measuring the amount of hydrogen it produces. Ideally, a catalyst should be cheap, stable, and produce a large amount of hydrogen in a short period of time.
Hydrogen can be stored and used to produce electricity when needed using devices called fuel cells. Some cars are already powered like this. If you'd like to find out more about producing hydrogen from sunlight, please join us at the Royal Society Summer Exhibition or follow us on Twitter at Storing Sunlight.